One of the biggest events in Europe in the biotech sector is without a doubt BioEurope, and this year's event was held in the beautiful German city of Leipzig. As well as lots of colour-coded booths for one-on-one meetings, there were also plenty of exhibitors, so Labiotech had an opportunity to find out about the biotech scenes in Portugal, Greece and Mauritius, as well as to talk to more than a dozen companies about their work.
We are actually a spin-off from the ETH in Zurich, and located in Zurich, and also Paul Scherrer Institute, and we are developing at the antibody-drug conjugates, so we have developed a novel link technology that really enables so the facile assembly, so hooking up the payload in one step onto an antibody, and we don't need to engineer the antibody in that regard. And also the resulting ADCs, they really show very promising properties. So we have now shown multiple times that we can substantially improve the therapeutic index compared to existing technologies, and which we are very excited about. So with the technology we have actually developed, we can generate very stable ADCs that are really enable to efficiently transport high amounts of toxins to the tumors and also efficiently release actually the payload there. And also because we don't lose the payload in that regard, we can then consequently achieve a very high therapeutic index. And that's why we are very excited about that, our technology, because we have shown it now in multiple different antibodies or ADCs. That's why we are super excited about that.
Right, and is it just applicable to tumors, or is it applicable to other things as well?
No, it's actually whenever there is an antibody involved or parts of the antibody where we attach the payload on it, like it's a certain fraction of the antibody, like an FC part it's called, we can work with it actually. So it's completely agnostic to which payload we want to attach on the antibody and also on the modality in that regard. So as long as there is this sequence or this glutamine 295 available, it works. So exactly. Yeah.
So I guess it's useful in things like individualized medicine if you can.
Yes, exactly. So we can also hook up radionuclides. So this is actually the lab where we're coming from, and we have also hooked up steroids and immune stimulants. So not only the classical conventional cytotoxic payloads, and we can even attach sort of two different payloads very easily. We have done that. We're also working on that actively, and also. So we can also control the amount of payload we have attached on the antibody very easily. So we can go up to DAR 8. So we have to understand that in one step we can attach 8 drugs on the antibody in a very controlled fashion. And I think that's really sort of unique in the ADC space.
So are you working with other companies to deliver their payloads?
Yes, exactly. So we see substantial interest. That's also why we are here, and we're very excited. So we are very busy in that regard. And we have collaborations ongoing, but it's still early in that regard, but it's progressing very well and everybody's happy, and we look forward to continuing our collaborations actually. Yeah.
Sure. So, and what kind of studies are you in the middle of at the moment? Are there any ongoing?
So yes, exactly. So in-house we are developing the lead asset further, so that's the focus of the company now. It's the CD79B targeting ADC. Where we really want to showcase that with our technology we want to sort of generate ADCs which have a significantly improved therapeutic index, because our competitor molecule was not able to go in a certain indication, and we really want to go because it was too toxic, sort of, you know, the therapeutic index, it was sort of too limited and the patients would not tolerate the treatment anymore. I mean, it was effective, but it was sort of stopped. And with our technology we want to take the same antibody and the same payload and attach it with our linker, so it's actually polyimide, and we take the same antibody and the same payload as is used in this ADC. And then we want to show that we can treat those patients where it has not been possible for this conventional ADC to go because it was too toxic, because of the linker, it's not stable, you cannot efficiently transport the toxin to the tumor, you lose the payload, and then you get cytotoxic, very strong side effects. And if we could show that, we would really, I think, probably be one of the first companies to really show that site-specific ADCs can substantially improve the therapeutic index. And we have shown that now in multiple different animals, head-to-head studies compared to this FDA-approved ADC, and we can really substantially improve the therapeutic index. So we have shown it preclinically, and that's why we're so excited about the molecule that we have shown it. And also in terms of findings we had in the monkey, we did not see any new toxicity that would be worrying for us. So if the data translates from preclinical studies into humans, and we have every reason to believe so, because we did not see any new things compared to what has been reported with the comparator molecule, But we have just seen it at much higher doses compared to this comparator molecule. We would have a blockbuster molecule, so because we could treat patients which are sort of running out of options in that regard, and we could also potentially set a new benchmark in this patient population, because there are other approved target modalities as well, but we think they're just too toxic. And our molecule, since we have shown that we have such a good efficacy and also remarkable tolerability, we will be able to treat those patients. So. And then we have validated technology, and that's why we are so excited. So that's one aspect we are working on at the moment. And then also we are working on broadening the pipeline further with solid tumor targeting ADCs. And here we are just evaluating also different sort of targets. We don't know yet which ones, so we are screening multiple ones, and in 6 to 9 months we hope that we will be able to nominate then the candidate, so we know which payload we want to work with, and also which antibody we want to work with. So. No, it's going very well in that regard, because we see a very high consistency among different ADCs we're working with. That we could, in all the sort of targets we're working, we try, if possible, to include a comparator. And we sort of generate superior data compared to what is known in that regard, or has been shown, exactly.
You said it was EZH that it spun out of in Zurich?
Yes, exactly. Yes. So it's located in Zurich. We are a spin out from ETH in Zurich and also Paul Scherrer Institute. And we're also very grateful for their support.
Seems to be a lot of things come out of there.
It's quite, yes, quite it's the, like an engine in that regard. And that helps also to support, because we could also incubate in their labs, and we could profit from very good conditions, and also, you know, because when you're a small company, you don't want to spend too much money on that regard. And we're grateful in that regard for the support. Mm-hmm. Yeah.